Hello everyone, myself Dr. Naresh Tambe. Welcome you all in this third series or third lecture of first module. I share the screen and we'll start the lecture. Yeah. Okay. So here now we are on thinking language intelligence lecture 3 now. So this will be last lecture for module 1. So here we are discussing about the intelligence now. Alfred Binet, one of the first psychologists who worked on intelligence, according to him, intelligence is the ability to judge well, understand well, and reason well. Okay. What does Alfred Binet say? What is intelligence according to him? Intelligence is the ability to judge well, to understand well, and to reason well. अल्फ्रेड बिनेटच्या मतानुसार बुद्धिमत्ता म्हणजे काय आहे की योग्य प्रकारे आपण जजमेंट करू शकतो, योग्य प्रकारे आपण अंडरस्टँड करणं आणि योग्य प्रकारे आपण समजून घेणं, रिझन करणं, आकलन रिझन म्हणजे आकलन करणं, याची जी अबिलिटी आहे त्याला तो बुद्धिमत्ता असं म्हणतो. सिमिलरली अकॉर्डिंग टू वेस्टलर, इंटेलिजन्स इज द ग्लोबल अँड अग्रिगेट कपॅसिटी ऑफ अन इंडिव्हिज्युअल टू ऍक्ट पर्पसफुली, to think rationally and to deal effectively with his or her environment. Okay, according to Westler, what? It's a capacity of individual to think, to act purposefully, to think rationally and to deal effectively with environment. All right. Westler cha matanusar kay ahe ki hi ek aggregate ekandarit ek capacity ahe manasachi ki to yogya prakare uddeshanusar kaam karu shakto, to rational vichar karu shakto, आणि तो त्याच्या वातावरणाशी इफेक्टिव्हली डील करू शकण्याची त्याची जी कपॅसिटी आहे त्याला इंटेलिजन्स असं म्हणावं असं वेस्टलर म्हणतो. ठीक आहे. नाव इम्पॉर्टंट कन्सेप्ट इन इंटेलिजन्स, देर आर सम इम्पॉर्टंट कन्सेप्ट वी शुड अंडरस्टँड. इज वन इज इंडिव्हिज्युअल डिफरन्स इन द इंटेलिजन्स. एव्हरी इंडिव्हिज्युअल इज अ डिफरंट, सो ऑल कॅनॉट बी हायली सुपिरियर इंटेलिजन्ट पीपल, ऑल कॅनॉट बी ॲव्हरेज, ऑल कॅनॉट बी बिलो ॲव्हरेज, ऑल कॅनॉट बी अबाय ॲव्हरेज. सो देर इज अ डिफरन्सेस इन इंडिव्हिज्युअल. Extreme intelligence is there. There are some people are mentally retarded and some are gifted in terms of intelligence. Means some people are superior in the intelligence. Some people are what we can say below average and even less than that in the intelligence. Okay. So to them we can call it as mental retardation. So mentally retarded may be mild retardation, profound mental retardation, severe mental retardation. There are different types also in that. Okay. Then nature versus nurture controversy. So it is like this controversy talks about whether the intelligence influenced by nature or due to nurture. So the conclusion is that both are equally important. Nature also means biologically what you have got, and how you are bringing your environment, what you have learned, what you acquired, experiences, that is also important, or that's also contribute into your concept called intelligence. Okay. Racial difference. So there are some people, maybe biased people, we can say that they say that there is a racial differences in intelligence. Some particular caste people or religious people or racial people are superior, and some caste people or religious people or racial people are less on intelligence. This controversy also there, but after a certain research done by objective researchers, they have concluded that intelligence is equally distributed among all caste communities, class. So there is no difference on the basis of caste and class and religion and race. Okay, there is no differences in that. Is intelligence is one general ability or several specific ability? That is also a question people think about. Is it one ability or is it several ability? Why these questions come? Because all we cannot become Sachin Tendulkar. We all cannot become Lata Mangeshkar or Udit Narayan or maybe Kumar Sanu or Sonu Nigam. We all cannot become expert in carom, expert in badminton, expert in anything. So, though that's also skill, that's also habit, that's also, there also require intelligence. We all cannot become engineer. All are not good in mathematics, all are not good in language, right? All are not good in speaking, right? So these things also require intelligence. And that's why this question people are asking, whether it's one ability or several specific ability. So we can see that there one researcher, one psychologist have spoke about specific abilities in terms of intelligence. Okay. आता हे मराठी सांगतो. इंडिव्हिज्युअल डिफरन्स इन इंटेलिजन्स. असं आहे की प्रत्येक माणूस हा वेगवेगळा असू शकतो, त्यामुळे त्यांची बुद्धिमत्ता सुद्धा वेगवेगळी असू शकते. ठीक आहे. मग एक्स्ट्रीम इंटेलिजन्स आणि मेंटल एक्स्ट्रीम इंटेलिजन्स म्हणजे अति जास्त किंवा अति कमी जे आहे त्याला आपण एक्स्ट्रीम म्हणूया. मग त्याच्यामध्ये अति कमी असणाऱ्यांना आपण रिटार्डेशन म्हणतो की त्यांना मेंटली रिटार्डेड आहेत असं म्हणतो आपण. आणि अति जास्त असणाऱ्यांना आपण गिफ्टेडनेस म्हणतो, गिफ्टेड म्हणतो की जे गिफ्टेड आहेत त्यांना खूप जास्त प्रमाणात बुद्धिमत्ता लाभलेली आहे. त्याच्यानंतर नेचर वर्सेस नर्चर कॉन्ट्रोवर्सी आहे, म्हणजे बुद्धिमत्ता ही नॅचरल आहे, तुमच्या हेरिडिटीमध्ये आलेली आहे की ती नेचरमुळे तुमच्या वातावरणामुळे विकसित झालेली आहे. तर दोन्ही गोष्टी इम्पॉर्टंट आहेत असं त्याचं कन्क्लुजन आहे. तुमची नैसर्गिक पण आलेली असते, तुमच्या हेरिडिटीमधनं पण आलेली असते, अनुवंशातनं आलेली असते, त्याचप्रमाणे तुम्ही काय शिकला, तुमचं नर्चर कसं झालं, तुम्ही कुठे आहात, तुमचं वातावरण काय आहे, त्याचाही तुमच्या बुद्धिमत्तेवर परिणाम होत असतो. काही लोकांनी असं म्हटलंय की जातीमुळे, धर्मामुळे, रेसमुळे डिफरन्सेस असतात बुद्धिमत्तेमध्ये, असं काहींचं मत असायचं पूर्वीच्या काळात. परंतु अनेक रिसर्चर्सने याचं सिद्ध केलेलं आहे की बुद्धिमत्ता ही इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्युटेड आहे आणि सर्व जाती धर्मांमध्ये जाती धर्मामुळे किंवा रेसमुळे किंवा कुठल्या प्रांतामुळे किंवा कुठे राहता म्हणून नव्हे, त्याच्यामुळे कुठल्याही प्रकारे आपली बुद्धिमत्ता ही कधी प्रभावित होत नसते. ओके. इज इंटेलिजन्स वन, बुद्धिमत्ता ही एकच ॲबिलिटी आहे की खूप साऱ्या ॲबिलिटीज आहे? तर ऑफकोर्स त्या खूप, काही लोकांचं म्हणणं आहे की ते एकच आहे, काही लोकांचं म्हणणं आहे त्या अनेक वेगवेगळ्या आहेत. कारण आपण सगळेच काय, आपण सचिन तेंडुलकर म्हणा, लता मंगेशकर म्हणा, किंवा आपण सगळेच काय मॅथमॅटिक्समध्ये खूप चांगले नसतो, का आपण सगळेच काय ऍक्टर शाहरुख खान बनत नाही, आपण सगळेच काय समान खान बनत नाही. सो प्रत्येकामध्ये काही ना काही वेगवेगळे हे आहेत, गुण आहेत, आणि त्यांना बुद्धिमत्ता लागते, त्या गोष्टी करायला बुद्धिमत्ता लागते. आपण सगळेच मॅथमॅटिक्समध्ये चांगलं नसतो, काही लोक असतात, काही लोक नसतात, है ना. तर याच्यासाठी बुद्धिमत्ता लागते. आणि म्हणून हा प्रश्न निर्माण होतो की मग इज इंटेलिजन्स ही एक, बुद्धिमत्ता ही एक जनरल ॲबिलिटी आहे की ह्या वेगवेगळ्या ॲबिलिटीज आहेत? तर त्याच्यावर पण एका मानसशास्त्रज्ञाचं मत आहे, ते पुढे आपण ऐकूया. ओके. नाव थिअरी ऑफ मल्टिपल इंटेलिजन्स अकॉर्डिंग टू अमेरिकन सायकोलॉजिस्ट हॉवर्ड गार्डनर. वी डू नॉट हॅव वन अंडरलाईंग जनरल इंटेलिजन्स बट इनस्टेड हॅव मल्टिपल. सो गार्डनर सेज दॅट देर आर नॉट वन बट देर आर मल्टिपल इंटेलिजन्स. सो ही टॉक्स अबाउट linguistic intelligence, logical, mathematical intelligence, spatial intelligence, musical intelligence, bodily kinesthetic intelligence, interpersonal intelligence, intrapersonal intelligence, naturalistic intelligence, existentialist. So these are different types he has spoke about. He said there is no one general intelligence, there are n number of, there are multiple. So what is linguistic is that people were having intelligence in the language, using, writing, speaking. Okay, so that you can call it as linguistic intelligence. Logical and mathematical intelligence, we know. What is spatial intelligence? It is used to perceive visual and spatial information and to conceptualize the world in the task like navigation and in art. So basically the people who are good in art, good in architecture, good in designing, good in creation, okay, they have this kind of intelligence, spatial intelligence. The musical intelligence need not to speak. Bodily kinesthetic intelligence need not to speak. You must be aware of what dancers or sportmen, sport persons, okay, they, how they use their body in sport, how they use their body in dance, how they use their body in different kinds of yoga and other things. So they know how to use their body effectively, which other may not. So that is called bodily kinesthetic intelligence. Interpersonal intelligence, it involves understanding others and acting on that understanding. And intrapersonal is what? It's ability to understand your own. Okay, so these two intelligence. Then what naturalistic intelligence is? The ability to recognize and classify plants, animals, and minerals. What is existentialist? It is ability to see the big picture of the human world by asking questions about life, death, and ultimate reality of the human existence. Okay. So this also intelligence that people, all people may not think about the human, they not think about life, death, reality, human existence. Other may not think, some people think. Others are in a different world. So this ability also is a kind of intelligence as per the Gardner. Now, intelligence and creativity. Terman in 1920s found that person with IQ were not necessarily creative. So person with high IQ may not necessarily creative, because creativity and intelligence is the different phenomena altogether as per the terminal. Now, researchers have found that relationship between creativity and intelligence is positive. However, though Terman says that there is no relationship, but the person with high IQ may not be necessary that he will be high on creativity. But of course, there is a positive relationship in intelligence and the creativity. Okay, that is what researcher says. Okay, म्हणजे बघा टर्मनचं असं म्हणणं आहे की बुद्धिमत्ता जी आहे, बुद्धिमत्ता ही नॉट नेसेसरी माणूस जास्त बुद्धिमान असणारा माणूस सर्जनशील असेल, तो सर्जनशील असेल अशी गॅरंटी देता येत नाही. परंतु तरीही काही रिसर्चरचं असं म्हणणं आहे की बुद्धिमत्ता आणि सर्जनशीलता ह्यांचा संबंध सहसंबंध कसा आहे, सकारात्मक आहे. स्टनबर्ग एट एल हॅव आयडेंटिफाईड 5 कॉम्पोनंट्स ऑफ क्रिएटिव्हिटी. What 5 components are, म्हणजे how we can become creative. So what we require to become a creative, that one thing is that expertise. You need to have expertise in particular thing to create something. Second, what? Imaginative thinking skill. You need imaginative thinking skill. Third is what? Venturesome personality. Like you may seek experiences, you may able to tolerate ambiguity and risk, and you may overcome by obstacles. So this kind of personality you should have. Then you can become creative, right? Then you need to have intrinsic motivation, not extrinsic. Intrinsic, like you have to be internally motivated to create something. So that is one factor need. And the fifth one, they said that creative environment. So you are creative, you should be creative, that's okay. But your environment also should be creative. Then that impact is there on you and then you become creative, right? So these 5 factors, they have, who said? Sternberg said. Okay, Sternberg ne mantla ki 5 factor ahet. किंवा 5 कॉम्पोनंट जे आपल्याला एक्सपर्ट करतात, जे आपल्याला क्रिएटिव्ह होतात. तर एक म्हणजे काय की आपल्यामध्ये ती एक्सपर्टी असणं, दुसरं आपल्याकडे ती कल्पनाशक्ती, कल्पनाशक्तीचा विचार, आपण कल्पनाशक्तीने विचार करण्याची कौशल्य आपल्याकडे असलं पाहिजे. आपली अशी पर्सनॅलिटी पाहिजे, व्हेंचरसम पर्सनॅलिटी, म्हणजे आपण नवीन एक्सपिरियन्स बघायला जातो, आपण ॲम्बिग्युटी म्हणजे काही अस्पष्टपणा असेल एखाद्या गोष्टीमध्ये, रिस्क असेल ते आपण ती स्वीकारण्याची आपली तयारी असते, आपण प्रॉब्लेम येतात त्याच्यावरती आपण मात करून पुढे येण्याची आपली तयारी असते, अशी पर्सनॅलिटी असेल तर आपण क्रिएटिव्ह असतो. आपल्यामध्ये अंतर्गत प्रेरणा असली पाहिजे आणि आपलं वातावरण सुद्धा तसं क्रिएटिव्ह असेल तर माणूस क्रिएटिव्ह होतो, असं स्टनबर्ग म्हणतो. ऑल राईट, नाव इमोशनल इंटेलिजन्स. नाव व्हॉट इज इमोशनल इंटेलिजन्स? इज इमोशन नथिंग, इट्स नथिंग बट अंडरस्टँड अदर्स इमोशन्स, अंडरस्टँड अदर्स reason their intelligence, emotions. Okay, I read this. Emotional intelligence refers to the ability to accurately identify, assess and understand emotions as well as effectively control one's own emotions. So understanding others also and controlling your own emotions also, if you have that, it means you are emotionally intelligent. So, all right. Now there is a different test by which we can measure emotional intelligence also. And if you are measuring emotional intelligence, so then it's called emotional quotient. And that is a formula to calculate it. Emotional quotient is equal to emotional age divided by chronological age into 100. So emotional age you will get by using that particular test or scale which you are using. You get emotional age, and chronological age is your biological age, and into 100. So if you count, you get emotional quotient. All right. Emotional intelligence म्हणजे काय? भावनिक बुद्धिमत्ता म्हणजे आपल्याला स्वतःच्या भावनांना नियंत्रण ठेवणं, दुसऱ्यांच्या भावना समजून घेणं, अंडरस्टँड करणं, असेस करणं, ही जी क्षमता असेल तिला आपण भावनिक बुद्धिमत्ता म्हणतो. आणि ती एखाद्या टेस्टच्या माध्यमातून मोजता येते, आणि टेस्टच्या माध्यमातून मोजली की त्याला आपण EQ म्हणतो. मग ते EQ काढण्याचं सूत्र काय आहे की इमोशनल एज भागिले क्रोनॉलॉजिकल एज गुणिले 100. इमोशनल एज आपल्याला ती स्केल किंवा ती टेस्ट वापरून मिळतं. क्रोनॉलॉजिकल एज म्हणजे आपलं शारीरिक वय आणि गुणिले 100 असं आपण केलं की आपल्याला EQ मिळत असतो. नाव असेसिंग इंटेलिजन्स, आता आपण आधी बघितलं इमोशनल इंटेलिजन्स, नाव ऍक्च्युअली इंटेलिजन्स, मेशरिंग इंटेलिजन्स कसं आहे तर बघा. सुरुवातीला इनिशियली बिनेट हॅज थॉट अबाउट दॅट मेशरिंग, हाऊ टू मेशर द इंटेलिजन्स ऑफ द स्टुडंट. सो ही हॅज कम अप विथ द स्केल, देन द स्केल बिकम बिनेट सायमन स्केल इज अडॉप्टेड. And then after adoption, that scale, So after adopting Binet-Simon scale, Stanford actually adopted Stanford Binet, then it becomes Stanford Binet intelligence scale. Okay. देन दिस स्किल ऑल्सो वी आर यूजिंग इन इंडिया एंड इट्स कॉल्ड विनेट कामत इंटेलिजेंट टेस्ट. ओके, सो द वे लाइक पीपल आर अडॉप्टिंग इन देयर कंट्री फॉर देयर पॉपुलेशन एंड देयर नेम इज बिकमिंग डिफरेंट. सो इनिशियली बिनेट एंड साइमन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इट एंड देन इट्स बिकम स्टैनफोर्ड बिनेट एंड इन इंडिया इट्स नाउ विनेट कामत टेस्ट. ओके, सो दिस इज वन वे ऑफ असेसिंग, बट नॉट ओनली दिस असेसिंग इंटेलिजेंस, नॉट दिस इज नॉट ओनली द वे. There are a number of other scale and tests are there, like Wechsler scale is there. Hold on, na. So there are other tests also, like CPM, SPM, Wechsler, and many more tests are there by which we can assess the intelligence. All right. Now, also we can see the formula for measuring intelligence. Same mental age divided by chronological age in 200. So mental age we get by using the test and your biological age and then into 100. So that way we can understand, we can get emotional quotient also. All right. Now there's a principle of test construction. So these four things are important: reliability, validity, standardization of test and norms. What is reliability? It can be defined as the extent to which a test consist result. Okay, so these are the three concepts. I'm starting again, there's a work going on. Reliability, validity, standardization of tests and norms. What is reliability? It is like nothing but consistency in the result. So if you are measuring a test on a one person for a period of suppose you are testing now and you are testing after some time, after some day, some month, result will remain same. So consistency in the result, that we can say that is nothing but the reliability. Then what is the validity? It means the extent to which a test measures what it's supposed to measure. Okay. But it means the extent to which a test measures what it's supposed to measure. So suppose we have developed a test to measure intelligence, or we have developed a test to measure personality. So that test, particular test, whether it's really measuring the personality or not, whether it's really measuring the intelligence or not, at what level it measuring, that we call it as a validity. Okay. Now, standardization of test is nothing but like you are testing your 1 minute. Huh? So standardization of test is nothing but when you have developed a test, you have to measure it for reliability, you have to measure it for validity. And then whatever score is there, if the proper reliability is there, proper validity is there, if that score as our scores are proper, we can call it as a standard test. And norms means when you develop a test, you have to test it on maybe 1,000, 10,000, 5,000 people and you get a score. That particular score you can compare when you are testing, afterward when you are testing on some person, the score is available to compare so that we can understand what we are testing now. It's going with what value on particular things. Suppose you have 10,000 people's data at particular age. Okay, so that 10,000 data of each age, for example, 1,000 data of particular age, 1,000 data of particular age. So you have one data to compare. When in the future, when you test result, you have a data to compare. So that particular data in a number, we call it as a norms. All right, huh? Okay, now. Okay, so with this particular chapter finished. Thank you so much. We'll meet very soon. For next module. Okay. Thank you so much.